What up? Thank you guys for joining in today. I am BK back with another banger. Today, we're going over, touching on what I did in the last video. Should have been the last video. The Symlink versus Alias. I'm going to touch on that today. Someone asked some questions on the topic, so I'm going to clear it up for him. He wanted to know if you use this, if you can use this to move your VSTs. And the answer is yes. I don't suggest anyone do that though. I suggest that you move the content, like the samples or the sound library, to an Alias or a Symlink link folder, and I'm gonna show you how to do that. You just wanted to know if you can get that done. All right, so let's get on over into, I believe I'm gonna do it in the MPC and show you guys. All right, so we're here in the MPC, and I have several instances of Nexus, right? I have about 1, 2, 3. I have about three Nexuses, Nexus plugins. And if anyone knows about Nexus that owns it, that bought it, you have the e-licensor. Without the e-licensor, you can't use it, right? Unless you got Nexus 3. But I'm gonna play this for you. All right, so you hear those sounds. Those sounds are coming from Nexus. All right, so let me get to the folder. So I have this folder. I created the folder, as you've seen it on the last video. I created the folder, and here it is. Nexus content, right? I created the Symlink, and then I copied it. I put it back here. So that is, here you go right here. Nexus content. Now, the original operation. The operation can't be completed because the original item for Nexus content can't be found. That's weird. It's not supposed to say that. So if you get that pop-up, don't worry about it because you have the copy of it on your external hard drive, so don't be alarmed. That's the difference with if you make an Alias, right, opposed to making a Symlink. That's one of the only downsides with it. All right, so I'm gonna make a Symlink of, I had a folder that I wanted to do. It was an audio. So this right here, this impulse responses, like, I canceled my subscription for Slate Digital, but I may get it again. So what I would do is I'd copy this, or I could simply drag it over to my external. It's 15 gigs. I'm gonna have to bring y'all back in. But right now I'm on 131 gigs. And once I free this up, it should push up my gigs. All right, so I'll bring y'all back in once this is all said and done. All right, so I copied it over to the external drive. I made a Symlink. Right click on the folder you want to make the Symlink. Go down to services and make Symlink link, right? It dropped it to my desktop. You want to delete Symlink from the end of the name, right? Delete Symlink from the end of the name of it, and then move it here. Authenticate, made a copy. I don't want it to be the copy. Move this to trash. All right. And as you can see, it's still telling me the operation can't be completed because the original item for the impulse responses can't be found. But you always have the original copy that's here. And the method to my, the way that I label this folder, first of all, I put a symbol in front of the name, so it'll always be at the top of the list. If you put a number or a symbol, generally it'll always be at the top of your list. But I keep mine as date modified. So, but if I switch to name, it'll be at the top. But anyway, this is my Mac HD, and the folders in which I pull from, I make sure I label it. Like, I just pulled that impulse responses from audio, so I put audio there, and then I put the original into that file. So in case I ever need to go back or put them back into where they belong, I just, okay, this is the Go library. So the Go library is Go and then option, right? So I know that's where that's at. Then library app support, library application support, right? Library application support, and then library audio. And honestly, I should make another folder and just name it library as well, but that's it. So I'm gonna play you the beat inside of the MPC with the Nexus. The Nexus sounds coming from the MPC, and that folder is on my external, right? Sound comes from MPC One Shots in Volume 2. So does this bass. Alright, so that's pretty much it, man. Any likes, comments, or concerns, please post it up in the comment section. The first video I did was a little bit extended because I went into full details on how to create the Symlink, how to add it to your computer and all that. So if you need to know how to add it to your computer, go to that video. The link should pop up anywhere around now. And visit that video if you want to know the details on how to add symbolic link to your folder. Again, make sure you back up your computer before you attempt to do anything that was displayed here, because you're messing with your hard drive and your directory. So you want to be certain that you have a backup before, you know, you make these adjustments, just in case, you know, anything messes up. You want to have a copy of it or a way to go back to, you know, the original point. That's pretty much it, y'all. Do remember that music is life. It is our DNA. Keep banging. Peace, love, and light. Till next time. Peace.